Hey guys, welcome back to another lesson in Substance Painter course for beginners. And in today's video, we are going to see how we can create a new project in Substance Painter and import our mesh. And we're also going to take a look at different bakers in Substance Painter. So let's import our model. So there are two ways to import our model. We can go to File and here click on the New, or we can press Ctrl N and it's going to show us the same thing. So first of all, we have this template here. So all these templates have different display settings, different shader settings, and different texture settings. But for this model, we are not going to select any of them. We are just going to select this select template. And in this file, you'll see the select here. And here you can import your mesh. So I'm going to import my model here. And this is the document resolution, and it defines the resolution of our texture sets. So you can change it anytime you want in Substance Painter. You have to go to texture set settings, and in the size you can change it anytime you want, and it can go up to 4K. So for this we are going to select the 2K, because if we select the higher resolution, it can make our software a little bit laggy if we are not using a high-end system. And we are going to change the normal matte format to OpenGL, because we are going to render this in Maya. So Maya uses OpenGL normal matte format, and we are going to keep rest of the settings to default and just click on OK. And here you can see your mesh. So I'm just going to change the viewport to 3D only. So before we start texturing, we are going to need to bake some mesh maps for this model. So we have to go to texture settings and go here in the mesh maps, click on this bake mesh maps, and you'll see this pop-up window here. Here is the output size, and it can go up to 8K. It's the output size of our texture that we are going to bake and export. So for this, I'm going to keep it 2048. And since we are not using any high poly mesh, so we don't have to import. But if you're going to make a high poly mesh detail on a low poly mesh, then you're going to have to port your mesh here by clicking on this icon. Now we have all these mesh maps. So I'm going to explain how these works. So normal map basically contains the information of normal angle that is made on the surface of our 3D mesh. And the world space normal contains the information about our mesh, that which parts of our model is facing up in the world space and which parts of our model is facing down, which helps all these generators and masks to work accordingly in Substance Painter. And ID map work with basic color information, and it masks and identifies parts of the model with color. And ambient occlusion stores the information of ambient shadows, which is created by the light available in our environment. And we have this curvature here. So curvature stores the information about our edge and the cavity in our model, which is again very helpful if you're using any dirt generator or edge wear damage or something like that. And here we have the position. So position map contains information about the sides, front and top and the bottom part of our model, which is again very helpful when we need to use the different kind of generators to texture our model. And at last we have this thickness here. So thickness map contains the information about our mesh, that which part of our mesh is thick and which part of our mesh is thin. So that's it. We just need to leave all these settings to default. Now we don't need to touch any of these settings. I'm just going to this anti-aliasing and increasing the subsampling to 2x2. So what anti-aliasing does, that it compute our textures to a higher resolution and then downscale it to our output size. So it helps us in getting rid of jagged and some hard edges. So that's pretty much it about these maps. So I'm going to click on this bake selected texture. So our bake is finished, and now you can see that we have all these ambient shadow information here on our model, and all that information stored in these maps are going to be used by the generators and masks in Substance Painter. So that's pretty much it. So that's how you can create a new project for your models in Substance Painter and import your mesh, then bake all these maps. And now you can start texturing on your model. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, then drop a like and subscribe to the channel if you're new. I'll see you in the next lesson. Thanks for watching.